Today is Thursday, June 20th at 6 a.m. Me and my business partner, Adam, have been working 18, 20-hour days over the past 3 days to fill approximately 100 orders per day. So I wanted to take you guys through some of that, as well as update you on some of the orders and what's going on. Just to start things off, guys, we are a new company. You know, everyone makes mistakes. We definitely did forget things here and there. So if you guys are missing anything from your order, just send us an email, info@frankiesfreerangemeat.com. We will send out the product the next day. I know there were some orders we were in a rush. You know, we forgot to put the beef tallow jars with the fat pack. But I promise you guys, these mistakes will not happen in the future when we are fully up and running with not playing catch up on all of these orders. The pemmican and jerky packages are going to be delayed until July 8th. What ended up happening was we were unable to find a production facility large enough to produce all the pemmican in time. So it's going to take us a little longer. If you guys ordered a pemmican or a jerky, any of the non-perishables, we will be filling all of those orders the week of July 8th. So guys, just hold out 3 more weeks. We're literally going to send out like 400 orders in 1 week, all non-perishable, super easy to do compared to the refrigerated stuff we've been doing lately. If you guys don't feel like waiting, just reach out again, info@frankiesfreerangemeat.com, and we'll figure something out. Maybe you want to cancel your order. In that fat pack is beef fat, marrow, and beef tallow. Since the quality of the fat of the animal coincides with the season, we don't have the most amazing orange looking beef fat yet, as some of the cows were still on hay. They were still on silage. You know, it's only the beginning of June, and a lot of these animals haven't been on the nutritious summer grasses yet. So over the next few months, you guys that purchase from us, expect the fat quality to increase drastically. You know, one of the issues with being local and trying to source as many of your products nearby to you is in New York, where it's very seasonally based, it can be difficult to source the best quality animal products at all times of the year. In the future, to address that scenario, you know, in the late spring, summer, and fall, we're going to source locally. At other times of the year, we might try to see if we can get like yellow, orange, higher quality summer pasture fat from other countries. We'll look into it. Our goal is to provide the highest quality product at the most affordable price, and we're looking to do that. But on more positive notes, we are getting a whole cow in on Monday of next week. So guys, please keep an eye out for a fresh beef box. What we're going to do is ship out the beef fresh, never frozen. It's literally being slaughtered tomorrow. So the beef is being slaughtered tomorrow. It's all coming in on Monday. We're going to run a fresh beef box special next week. So if you don't place your order next week for the fresh beef, it's not going to be fulfilled. So we're going to catch the orders next week and fill all the orders the following Monday. So if you guys want a fresh beef box, we're going to put it online. I'm not sure if I'm going to list what cuts are in it. It's probably going to be, you know, 30 to 40% ground beef that's freshly ground. And then the rest of the box is going to be an assortment of roasts, maybe a couple of steaks here and there, maybe some organs thrown in. We're going to have to see what we get from this cow and what the total yield is. On the fatty beef pack, we said we were giving people over 10 pounds of high quality grass-fed fatty beef. The fatty beef wasn't as fatty as we liked it to. So what we ended up doing was giving people like 13, 14 pounds of meat. We gave people way too much meat, basically. So you guys that ordered the fatty beef pack for this first round kind of lucked out and got like 13 to 14 pounds of the cuts we were offering. What we're doing to increase the fat content of those products in the future is we're changing up the cuts a bit and we're sourcing a little bit differently. So the next round of fatty beef packs will have less poundage of meat. It will be coinciding with what we said we were going to offer, and the fat content's going to be a bit higher. We did find a source of pasture-raised chicken. They're these nice, like 2.5-3 pound chickens, completely delicious, very moist, coming fresh. So we'll be offering those probably around $16 or $17 per chicken starting Saturday. And then next week, we're going to see what fish we can get our hands on. So things are moving really quickly, guys. Me and my business partner are really working hard. We're really excited to make this happen. We know we're sending out the highest quality product there is right now, especially online. And we're going to keep barreling you guys with the highest quality, you know, most nutrient-dense animal foods. And we're going to make it affordable. Me and my business partner, Adam, killing ourselves in a kitchen for 18 hours a day is why we are able to do this for you guys. No one is crazy enough. No one is going to put in this much work and this much effort into doing these things. So the next like 10 or 15 minutes or so is going to be me going through day one to day three. And let me tell you, boys and girls, it was not fun. As I said, if you guys have any issues with your orders, if you I forgot anything, if you're not happy with the quality of the product, email info@frankiesfreerangemeat.com. We will either refund your product or we will send out a new shipment as soon as we can. All right, we just finished boxing up all the orders for Monday and it was just short of a nightmare. Well over 100 packages. Here we got Adam helping the UPS guy load some of the boxes.
Here we go.
What a nightmare. We got some more back there. More over here. More boxes over here. And we got the rest of the boxes in here staying cool. We have to do this two more times this week, and I'm honestly not sure if Frankie Boy is gonna make it, but we'll see. Started the day at about 6:30 a.m. It is now 10 p.m. and we are not having fun, but we need to fill these orders, boys and girls. So we did 100 orders today. That was from about 6 a.m. to 3 p.m. and then we had to prepare meat for the orders tomorrow. So just to give you guys a look in our cooler right now, I know it's a little bit dark and noisy in here, but here we have our marrow bones. Here we have some stuff for the fatty beef, some more fatty beef stuff. You guys can't even see this. Let me open this. There's some steaks back here, more steaks down there. All beef fat over here, bunch of organs and stuff in that corner too. So that cooler is full now, but it was actually full earlier. We emptied it and then we filled it up again with product. So, you know, catching up on 3 months worth of orders is insanity. In this cooler over here, we have some more fresh product. There's some beef fat over here, more steaks and cuts of meat down there. Over here is all of our cheeses. So we have, you know, our Etivaz, our Gruyere, we have some Parmigiano Reggiano, have a bunch more cheese down there with some extra meat. I have to get home and film a video for tomorrow and then we have to get up at about 5:30 a.m. and do this again. But hopefully it will be better in the future and I won't have to kill myself to get you guys high quality nutrient dense animal foods. It is now the next day, Tuesday, June 18th. Got home around midnight last night, had to film a video for you guys. Ended up getting to bed at 3 a.m. Woke up at 6 a.m. I'm back down here now. It's 2 p.m. We filled all 100 orders today in about 5-6 hours, so we really banged them out. We have a bunch of prep work to do for another 100 orders tomorrow, and then Frankie Boy's nightmare 3 days will be over. I've worked very hard some jobs. The closest I've worked as hard was a catering event where I stayed up 3 days straight prepping food. So I've done this before. It's not fun. I haven't eaten for 2 days. Haven't really been drinking much water. But Frankie Boy is carved out of marble, so I'll be fine, boys and girls. I did get a stress fracture on my wrist. I don't know if you guys could see this, but this is all like internal. Like I didn't bang it on anything. It's really swollen from the inside.
And whenever I squeeze anything, you know, my wrist hurts a lot. So hopefully, you know, tomorrow is the last day I'm dealing with this, and then I'll be able to recover for a few days. But yeah, that doesn't look good if it's that swollen from the inside. Let's actually take a walk over to the cooler. And we went through pretty much everything in here. You know, the cages are almost empty. I can't even hold this camera, it's hurting my wrist. Then in the other cooler, we went through just about everything here too. So everything is really emptied out. And we gotta restock it for tomorrow. It's 2 p.m. now. If Frankie Boy stays focused, I should be out of here by 6, 7, or 8 o'clock, hopefully. And then I'll actually get home, I'll get some sleep, and I'll be able to film a video early tomorrow morning for you guys. I probably mentioned it earlier in this video already, but today is the day that the chicken actually came in. So we're gonna test a chicken product. Hopefully we like it and it's good, so you guys will have a poultry option. It is not going to be 100% corn and soy free yet. That's something we're looking to do in the very near future. We got Adam back over here.
What's going on, guys?
Picking up some, he went to pick up some cash.
And free cash.
Picking up, this is the sketchiest bank, right? This is the worst part of New York, one of the worst parts of New York, really.
There's a line every time. Today there was a food stand outside, people were going crazy.
What do they do, money orders only, like over there?
The ATMs weren't working, I had to go to the teller.
It's around 8 o'clock now, not too long of a day compared to yesterday, we're at 13 hours. The first orders went out really smooth, filled 90 orders real quick. Then we did a little bit of a mistake on the par count, and we had to, you know, cryovac and vacuum seal some stuff for the last 10 orders. You know, we banked out 90 orders in 3 hours, and then it took us 2 hours to fill just 10 orders. So we're gonna make sure to do some prep tomorrow. We are short on a few products, so we're getting an emergency delivery, and we're gonna use that to fill another 100 orders approximately tomorrow. And then anyone who hasn't received their order tomorrow, we're gonna fill a couple more next week. But anyone who ordered after June 4th, we're looking to fill your orders by the first week of July. So you guys aren't gonna be waiting nearly as long as you did for the pre-orders. But overall, I'm gonna go home, try to relax, get some sleep for once, and then I'll film a video in the morning before I come in. We just gotta come in tomorrow, fill some more orders, cut the meat that comes in, separate the fat that comes in. A lot of vacuum sealing today. I did probably, you know, a few hundred pounds of marrow bones, a bunch of veal liver, did a bunch of steaks, bunch of beef, just a whole lot of time on the vacuum seal machine. So really making sure this product is as fresh as possible. Being in this kitchen for 12 hours a day, getting blasted by EMF, radiation, you know, not eating, not sleeping, a recipe for disaster. But I have some secrets. Here we have NAC, N-acetylcysteine. It's a precursor to glutathione. And you might notice that when you have a headache and you eat something, you feel better. There are usually amino acids present in your food that act as a precursor for the glutathione antioxidant. NAC is great. It's really what I use to fix my headaches. I don't take Tylenol anymore after discovering this. I have to look into a brand that doesn't have as many additives, but this stuff is really a lifesaver for headaches. NAC is also great for biofilms, for people with SIBO or Candida. It has a lot of uses. And we have vitamin D3. So I usually use like 10 to 15,000 of this throughout the day. You know, a couple drops when I get in, a couple drops into the day, and then a couple drops, you know, in the middle of the day. So these two things really help me keep my energy levels up and not shake my camera like a lunatic. I'm hoping I sleep a little bit better. Usually when I fast for a long period of time, I don't sleep too well. So I should only need like 6 or 7 hours of sleep to feel good, but I'm questioning if I'm going to be able to get that much. It is Wednesday and I feel like I am going to die. My eyes are bloodshot. I only got a few hours of sleep last night again. I had to wake up early to film a video for the YouTube channel. Now I gotta pick up some stuff. Go back down to the production facility, get the orders wrapped up for this week, and then hopefully Frankie Boy can get some sleep and possibly eat something. So
A lot of stuff to get through. I'm going to try to film some more stuff today because I know I haven't been showing you guys anything lately. Maybe we'll have some product to look at. But all we're really doing is, you know, filling the fridge and coolers up with meat, shipping out orders, sending out orders. And it's, you know, 12, 16, 18 hour days. So things are going to slow down a lot once we catch up on these orders. But I'll see you guys when I get down there.
It's actually Thursday morning, and I'm sorry, guys. I was unable to film on Wednesday when I got down there. We ended up having a couple things happen. Our delivery for meat was late. We needed an emergency drop on some beef and some fat. So we were really scrambling to get the rest of the orders filled. My business partner, Adam, actually had about 50 orders filled already. So we were kind of waiting on the product to come in, and then we had to scramble in 2 hours to prep and box 50 orders, but we got it done, boys. And normally I would be able to blog and show you guys more stuff, but another reason I didn't want to film down there is because the neighborhood is really bad. One of the worst neighborhoods in New York City, and I literally can't be filming on the street. Someone will literally run up to me and take the camera out of my hands. Another reason I haven't been able to film is because I've been doing a lot of things, still helping with my family to some degree, take care of my sister. This is what I want to show you guys over here. So I pack all of my meals for my sister every day. For those of you guys who don't know, my sister is mentally disabled, and I helped her lose a lot of weight. So this is her breakfast, pasture-raised eggs with raw butter. Sometimes I sneak a little bit of iodine and vitamin D3 in there. Her lunch is usually some bologna from a local farm. This is something we're going to try to make for you guys too. I really like the product. It's very approachable. It's great for kids. It's great for people that don't like eating certain products. Her snack is almost always raw cheese. I believe this is raclette. I like it a lot. And her dinner is pastured pork. This is the Iberico pork that I was showing you guys last week. This is what I've been cooking for her. I just throw the pork on the grill, and then I put a little maple syrup and raw butter on it. Back here, some lamb brains for me. And I got some pork ribs marinating, and that leaked everywhere. Holy shit, I gotta clean that up. So I got some pork ribs back there marinating in coconut aminos, honey, and salt. Coconut aminos are like a healthy soy sauce, essentially. But that's what I have for my family. I picked up a farm order of about a dozen eggs from a farm. These were actually from Whole Foods to get us by, but normally I just get eggs from a local farm. Back there is some raw cream. So we have some organic raw cream back there, some more raw cream over here. I actually left the bacon that I was smoking inside my grill last night, so I gotta go grab it because it's raining now. But we're gonna test that out because we will have bacon for you guys in the future. And I also just got in my fresh meat order from our local farm. So Frankie Boy is getting Frankie's meat in his mouth as well. I got some chuck roll and short rib as well as, that's it. That's what I got in my fridge downstairs. So a bunch of quality meat for everyone all around. So I can't thank you guys enough for joining me for this vlog. You know, we mentioned earlier in the vlog, hey, reach out if you guys have any issues with your orders. We're really excited to be providing you guys with really high quality animal products. Like I'm literally looking over every single thing that's happening. You know, some things are going well, some things are, you know, sometimes shit happens, but I'm doing the best. I think I have the highest level of understanding of quality animal products in America. I really don't think anyone has messed around as much as me on a carnivore keto diet, has worked in culinary, has worked in kitchens, has a hospitality background. You know, my combination of food knowledge and understanding of animal foods is unparalleled. So if there's a guy that can get you the best animal foods, it's going to be Frankie Boy. Really looking forward to the stuff we're launching over the next few weeks, guys. We got the fresh beef box next week. We're going to have chicken and fish as well. So maybe you guys can let Frankie Boy kill himself for another couple weeks and catch up. And then we have even more crazy products that we're launching. You guys are gonna spend your whole bank accounts on these products that come out. We have some really good ideas that we haven't been able to do yet. So if you guys would like to check out frankiesfreerangemeat.com, place an order with us, see what we're looking to do in the future as well. It's on there. Guys, raw dairy, we want to make it happen. We want to make wild game meat happen. We might have some venison and wild boar soon. Let me know what you guys think of those cuts. Outside of that, you guys enjoy the rest of your week.